I've had some Frank Hive DMs talking about, oh, you know, all the games that he's played, they've won. Doesn't make mistakes, still plays defense. the lady's not having any of it. But I don't know where he gets in this rotation. Maybe if Rivers continues this, maybe that's Frank's window. You know, the dogs are gonna eat. And so maybe he gets that opportunity.
Yeah, man, we gotta see who's healthy and who's hitting shots and who's not, and then we can make our decision from there, really. Like, he's been shooting well from three this year. Granted, it's a short sample size. He's like 50-something% from three. Mm-hmm. But he just has to shoot more. If he's able to shoot more and play defense, there'll be a role. He'll be a Kev. You know what I'm saying?
If he's able to gotta knock down those shots.
Yeah. He has to take the shots. That's what it is.
I just don't understand how much longer I'm supposed to give him. I don't understand why it's two different expectations. And yes, I get it. RJ comes from Duke, comes from one of the best programs in the country, and people feel like he's had a silver spoon and he's been bottle fed and blah, 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 blah. I've heard all the rhetoric. I've heard all the narrative. It's been 4 years for Frank. Four. Like, how much longer are we supposed to wait for him to figure out where he fits in this team, what his role is? Like, you're either helping or you're not. Like, either you're occupying a roster space and contributing, or you're just occupying a roster space. This is not about me being a Frank hater. This is about me being a Knicks fan who wants to start winning. And if he's not going to contribute because there's a lot of other pieces that we're trying to figure out work, if that worked before him, then we need to send him, DSJ, and whoever is not contributing to this team elsewhere and replace him with somebody who can actually go ahead and contribute to this team. It's not about being a hater. I'm just tired of waiting. This is like, I would have broken up with this guy. This was a relationship. Where's my proposal?
Cold-blooded. Like, no time to wait. This next man up. There's fives going on in the chat right now, Jails. What do you have to say, man?
All I have to say is this, man. I absolutely agree with you, Ashley. If he's not contributing, he should. I absolutely agree with you. But he was contributing the little minutes he was playing this season, and he got injured. Unfortunately, I feel like the people are saying that, you know, his play has been his biggest obstacle. And I feel like it's part of it, but I feel like his biggest obstacle has been his injury history, man. He's been injured.
It's injuries. You gotta be available.
But you know what, though? That's the name of the game. I can name, not only in basketball, but also in football, a lot of players whose careers were cut short or they were traded and sent elsewhere because injuries were just preventing them from contributing to a team.
Yeah, absolutely.
I'm not saying it's his fault. I'm not saying that it's his fault he's injury prone. I'm just saying it's been 4 years. Like, you have to go. It's no longer like now we gotta, it's no different than what happened with Justice Winslow.
But I do feel like if given time, he'll have a 3-and-D role on his team or whatever team he lands him. So
here's this time thing again. How much more time do you want me to give him? What would be a good amount of time for you? Should I wait 6 years? How much longer do you need me to wait?
We waited this long to get what we're at right now. What's another week? What's another day? What's another few games, man? You know what it is, too? I feel like this team has been missing a guard, a guy who can defend multiple positions for a long time. And I feel like we kind of have that in Frank. He's just not healthy. But I feel like if he ever does get healthy, he will have a role on this team.
And if I can ever, you know, sing and dance in high heels at the same time, I could be Beyonce. Basketball is not only talent. Yes, talent plays a huge part in it, but availability to your team is a big part of the game. And unfortunately, we don't know what consistent talent or what consistent contributions we can get from Frank because he's never available. So how much longer are you supposed to wait for somebody who's never available to show you what he can contribute when he can't contribute to it consistently?
I am not debating that the availability has been a problem. That I understand that 100%, but I don't want to get on this thing where he's like, oh, Frank is trash and he's a useless NBA player, and that's what I feel like a lot of the conversation steers to. It's like he's a useless guy, and I don't think that's true at all. I feel like he played defense. I feel like when he first got here, he was the number one pick and roll guard in the NBA for a reason. I feel like his free throws have always been on point. I feel like his shooting has been trending up for years, and it's just that he needs to be healthy and put it together. And he might not put it together on this team because of the circumstances, because of the players here, because of the chances are running out. But I do feel like at some point he will put it together.
Okay, this won't be in New York. That's fine. I don't have a problem with him putting it together. I think this won't be here. I wish him the very best. I hope he gets healthy and I hope he gets it together and I hope you see him flourish, but it's not going to be here because it's been too much time that has been given to him. And in a rebuilding era, and when you're trying to win, because the Knicks are trying to win eventually, I can't continue to wait for somebody who I can't rely on. And that's the unfortunate part. And that's what sucks about injuries in this league and in any league, is that sometimes it does not go down to your talent. Sometimes it's about how you contribute to a team. And your talent kind of goes out the window when you can't utilize that talent because you're never healthy. And that's the suck part, but it's the reality. It's been 4 years. Like, I don't know how much longer we're supposed to give him. That's just how I feel about it.
You know, I guess, you know what? It depends on you if you see the value or not. I think that's what it boils down to, right? If you see the value, then when his contract runs out, you'll resign him for a cheaper deal to see where he at. If you don't see the value, go to another team. They'll sign for a contract and he'll carve out a role for his team. He'll be like a Marcus Smart who kind of plays multiple defenses and shoots threes and does what he does. If you don't see the value, you don't see the value. I can't make you see the value, but I see the value in a guy who can play, who can shoot the three, play defense, and be a multiple positional player who can guard multiple positions. Right. And also set people up on occasion when given a chance.
All right, that's a bell. That's it. Great debate. Love that energy. Who won in the chat? Throw your winners in the chat. I was just sitting back. People in the chat was like, yo, CP got the popcorn ready. Oh, I loved it. That was great energy. Great debate. Even off of a win. The passion of the Knicks fans. Let's go. Throw your winner in the chat. Who won that debate? Listen, my perspective, short and sweet, is I see both sides to it. I see both sides. I see JL's side where there could be value to Frank if he's on, if he's hitting his shots and he's defending well. Yes, there is value in having a utility guy, a glue guy, a multi-positional defender if he's on. Also, in fairness, this is his, Fizdale, Miller, Hornacek, Tibbs, fourth coach in 4 years. Very hard to gain that stability. At the same time, like Alan Hahn came on this show, he agreed with Ashley. It's put up or shut up time. Only the dogs will eat. And as I got my training camp report coming into this, I was told that the point guard situation right now, they're going to give DSJ the chance. They're going to give Peyton the chance. Frank was not in that conversation for the point guard situation because they don't know if he can play the role. They're not confident that he can play the role. So part of it is on him. He has to put up and deliver. And the most important thing is his availability. And every single year he's hurt, whether it's a groin injury, whether it's a paper cut. Now it's a knee sprain that's kept him out for some time. So if he's not going to be here, the potential is worthless. You know what I'm saying? And it's going to be a next man up. If Austin Rivers is on his game, he's going to play. We already know Bullock's spot in the rotation is going to be solidified. When Obi steps his game up, he's going to be in it. Who knows what Kev? So I don't think Frank is going to be guaranteed anything, but I think the bottom line is he has to take it.